Amen. God allows the hammer to fall on his head. Hallelujah. We're so grateful. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. That God will fight our battle. The scripture says, many afflictions of the righteous, but the Lord shall deliver him out of them all. We're going to have trials, but God is going to bring us out. We're going to have tribulation, but God is going to see us through. Amen. Hallelujah. I decided I will not be a victim of the enemy. Hallelujah. I'm going to be victorious in my walk with the Lord. Hallelujah. Somebody say, praise the Lord. Hey, God, I feel your presence tonight. Let's do this real quick. We thank God for all of you out tonight. Amen. Jesus. Hallelujah. We're going to get them. Any questions tonight? Any questions? Anybody have a question they wanted to ask and they never got a chance to ask? We're going to have to see. Amen. Minister Sims. He missed you. Praise the Lord. The weekend. Amen. Glad to see us. Amen. Evangelist Wright tonight. Amen. Glad to see all of y'all out here tonight in the name of the Lord. We had a wonderful prayer today. And the Lord was in our midst. Hallelujah. And we thank God for him coming back. Praise the Lord. Thank the Lord. All right. Grab your Bibles. Anybody have any? Nobody? Nobody have a question? All right. All right. All right. So I can ask y'all a question, right? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I'm going to ask you to turn. Our lesson tonight is coming from 2 Corinthians. 2 Corinthians. Chapter 4. But before we get there, let's turn chapter 4. I think that's what I want. Yes, chapter 4, 2 Corinthians chapter 4. Mm-hmm. Now, I'm trying to get down to the 8th and 9th verse, but if the Lord's will, we'll get there. But we're going to start off at verse 2, and I want you to get it. Let's see, can we get down into the word one more time? Hallelujah. All right, I'll get that scripture later that I wanted to ask you a question from. Praise the Lord. Let's go.
But have renounced the hidden things of dishonesty.
Now, this actually scripture that we're dealing with here tonight is actually Paul writing his second book to the Corinthians. The Corinthians, I think I've mentioned it, and if I did not have mentioned it, was one of the most talented groups or talented of people in the entire scripture. They were so talented, yet God had put so many gifts among them that these folk, it seems as though that they could do some of anything and still be in the church. Hallelujah. And that's the way it is with the world or with the church today. You see people, it seems to be that talented people are more receptive to go astray than people who are striving, who thrives to be saved. Just only to be saved. I'm not doing no extra stuff, but I just want to be saved. Hallelujah. But people who can do everything, they can sing, they can preach, they can pray, it seemed to be that they can kind of drag their feet along and do some of anything and still stay in the church. Now, this may not be good for y'all right now, but it's going to get better after a while. It seems to be, that's the way it seemed to be. Mother, it seems it take everything I got, praise the Lord, to stay saved. And I just can stay saved. And here's an individual, cuss, swear, cheat, do some of everything, and have no problem at all. And when he get up in the pulpit, amen, the things just soar right on through. And I'm pulling my hair out, and still things don't work right for me. I don't know. I don't understand that. But this is the way it seemed to be with the Corinthian church. If you will note very closely, this Corinthian church got so bad until a man took his daddy's wife, praise the Lord, and was staying with his daddy's wife, hallelujah, and his dad's wife become his wife. And the church people, when Paul got on them about it, the church people went in agreement with the boy. Instead of telling the man that you should not have your daddy's wife, but the church people agreed with the man and said he should have her. It was right for him to have her. Now, you talk about a mess, hallelujah. This church world can get real messy. Hallelujah. And this is what Paul was saying. Look what he says. Therefore, seeing we have this ministry, as we have received mercy, we faint not. Hallelujah. As we have received this ministry, we faint not. The word faint means to quit. It means to give in. It means to take down. Hallelujah. It means to stop. I have received mercy with this ministry, and I can't quit. I can't stop. I got to tell it like it is. Sin is sin. Praise the Lord. And there is no excuse for sin. If we wrong, we're wrong. Hallelujah. There is no say gray areas in God. God said you're either right or you're wrong. Are y'all still with me? And Paul, and this, listen what Timothy said, listen what Paul's saying, and I have re-announced the hidden things of dishonesty. Yes. Praise the Lord. Things that was dishonest, I've been talking about it, I've been saying it, and I'm going over it again. Yes. Every now and then you have to go over the word of the Lord. Amen. It is a shame that you can't preach one time and that's it. But no, that's because we can't do that, because the devil is always mixing some stuff up. And every now and then I got to go over it again to make sure that you know what is right and what is wrong. In other words, you need to be stirring up every now and then. You need to be told what God has said about a certain subject. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. The wages of sin is death, and the gift of God is eternal life. Every now and then I need to tell you something, that you can't do that and be saved. Salvation has a line to it. Amen. Hallelujah. And there's guidelines when it comes down to the church. If you're going to stay in the church, there's guidelines to stay in here. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. You can't live like you want to live and stay in the church. Oh, no, 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 no. There's guidelines in the church. There's rules. There's regulations in the church. God has set up boundaries in the church. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. When God set up the boundaries, hallelujah, you can get close to one of these boundaries, and the Holy Ghost will let you know you're getting too close now.
Oh yeah.
All right, look like I'm gonna have to shout by myself. Praise the Lord. But I'm telling you, hallelujah, when you get too close to a rule, a regulation, the Holy Ghost will speak out and tell you, hallelujah, you're getting too close now. Hallelujah, you just can't live on the edge. Hallelujah, you can't live on the edge. God don't want us to live on the edge. God wants us to go and step on in there. Praise the Lord. Get in the middle of it. Hallelujah. And tell the devil, I'm saved now. And don't be ashamed to tell nobody, I'm saved. I belong to the church. That used to be me, but it ain't me now. Phew. Jesus. Oh, come on. Hallelujah. And listen what he says. Of dishonesty, not walking in craftiness and handling the word of God, deceitfulness. I'm not walking. Craftiness is what? Hallelujah. What is craftiness?
Sneaky.
If somebody is crafty, what is they? Inventive. Let's use the word smart. Praise the Lord. Somebody trying to be smart. You're trying to get over on somebody. I'm not using the word of the Lord for my advantage. Praise the Lord. I'm not hiding behind nothing in the word. Hallelujah. Glory to God. God don't want you to hide behind nothing. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Especially when it brings gratitude, a gratification to your flesh. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Yes, that's right. Praise the Lord. Right. Anything that will satisfy your flesh and bring a gratification to your flesh, God don't want you standing behind that. He want to be the only one that gives you gratification. Hallelujah. God wants to be the lover of your life. And God wants to be the cherisher of your spirit. Hallelujah. God wants to be the centerpiece in your life. Hallelujah. He wants you to look to him for everything. Hallelujah. Look to him for your source of joy. Look to him for your source of peace. Look for him for your source. Hallelujah. Lord, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory to the hallelujah of your gratification. Hallelujah. Look at Jesus. Look at Jesus. Say, Lord, now if I'm gonna feel good, you're gonna have to make me feel good. Lord, if I'm going to get deliverance, you're going to have to give me deliverance. I'm not going to no soothsayer. I'm not going to no palm reader. Pray, you're going to have to read my palm and make me feel better. Y'all might as well come on up in here. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. I'm hallelujah. I'm hallelujah. I'm not going to sell myself short from anything. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. That will take the place of God. Hallelujah. You got to be sold out for the Lord. You got to be sold completely out for God. You got to say, for God I live and for God I die. I'll let nothing separate me from the love of God. And when that thing starts stepping over on your trenching on your love for God, you have to learn how to turn it loose. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. And some people you have to turn loose too. Some things you have to walk away from too. Hallelujah. Some ideas you have to throw in the trash. Hallelujah. And some teaching we have to get away from. Because if the teaching is against the will of God, then hallelujah, you got to get away from that. And listen what he said. Read.
By manifestation of the truth.
The word manifestation is to be made known or to be revealed. The cover has to be pulled off for it. I got to manifest the truth to you. And I got to make the truth so plain when you read it, it'll come clear to you. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Oh my God. Lord, I feel like running around in here. Praise the Lord. See, everybody don't have the truth. Praise the Lord. You that have the truth will be made known. Truth, hallelujah, has to be revealed. In other words, cover has to be pulled off the truth to you. Truth has to be brilliant. Truth brilliant means to be clear or to be made clear. Hallelujah. And everybody, the truth has not been made brilliant to. Everybody, the truth has not been revealed to. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. But us that are saved, the truth has been revealed to us. You ought to know, praise the Lord. Hallelujah. You ought to know that living right is right if nobody lives. You ought to know, praise the Lord, there is one Lord, one faith, and one baptism. Hallelujah. Even if nobody else don't believe it, you ought to believe that there is one faith, one baptism, and one Lord, and one Father of all, who is in you all, who is above all. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. And that one God, his name is Jesus. Lord have mercy, I feel the Holy Ghost. Reason.
Commending ourselves to every man conscious.
I want all of y'all to look at me. Hallelujah. I'm not going to tell you one way to live, praise the Lord, and then tell you don't live like I live, but live like I say. No, I'm going to tell you I am your example. Praise the Lord. I say that to the brothers. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. If you want to know how to treat your wife, look at how I treat mine. Treat your wife like I treat my wife. Love your wife like I love my wife. Hallelujah. Do by your wife like I do by my wife. Hallelujah. And you'll be all right.
You'll be all right.
Hallelujah. Somebody say praise the Lord. All y'all, praise the Lord. I know it's hard sometimes, but you got to do it anyhow. Amen. God, hallelujah. Praise the Lord. The way the way we live for Jesus is not the way is hard, but the devil make it hard. Because Jesus said, my yoke is easy and my burden's light. It's not hard to live right, but the devil may. Sis, don't do that. Hallelujah. Don't do that. Praise the Lord. I worked too hard today. Praise the Lord. Amen. The devil will make it hard for you. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. But when it comes to the scripture, the Bible says, cast all your cares upon him, for he careth for you. When it seems like you can't make it any further, just cast it all on the Lord. Tell God, hallelujah, I'm your problem. Glory to God. I don't have a problem. That's your problem. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. I don't have a burden. That's your burden. I don't have a problem. Hallelujah. Glory to God, because I belong to you. And you promised to work things out for me. You promised never to leave me, never to leave me alone. You told me you would be with me in the sixth trouble, and in the seventh trouble you would not deny me. You said, praise the Lord, if I hold on to you, praise the Lord, you will bring me out. And then you told me to stand still, and that's what I'm doing. Hallelujah. And and you would fix it for me. And while I'm standing here, you told me to be patient. Hallelujah. And that's what I want to do. All I want to do is praise you, because I got your word. Lord, have mercy. Hallelujah. Somebody say praise the Lord. Tell I just come somebody tell them I got his word. Hallelujah. And when you got his word, all you got to do is be subject to his word. Hallelujah. And watch God work it out. God never told you to work out nothing. He told you to hold your peace. Hallelujah. And I'll fight your battle. Stand still and see the salvation of the Lord. I'm doing that. I'm doing that in a praise. And in order for you to praise God, you must be comfortable with God. Hallelujah. You get that one seat down. You got to be comfortable with his word. You got to be comfortable with his love. I am so happy with the love of God. Let's see the hands of those who are not comfortable with the love of God. You want something else. Praise him. You ought to be happy with the love of God. I'm just happy God is loving me. As nasty as I was, I'm just happy God loved me. As much sin as I was in, I'm just happy God is loving me. Come on, praise the Lord. Hallelujah. As tied up as I was in, as tied up. Praise the Lord. I'm just so glad. I'm tickled silly that God is still loving me.
Hallelujah.
Oh, come on. Hallelujah. It takes the love of God to love a sinner. Come on. Hallelujah. Because most of them is contrary to everything. And don't tell me you wasn't contrary. You wasn't saved. Praise the Lord. That means you was contrary. Lord have mercy. Read, sir. I'm almost there.
If our gospel be hid,
listen what he says.
It is hid to them that are lost.
Now, go ahead, sir. If the gospel be hid, it means that the revelation of the knowledge of God has not been revealed to you yet. Amen. So it means you're still lost. Yes. Uh-huh. Hallelujah. Because you can only get saved when the revelation comes to you.
Amen.
You can't get saved, praise the Lord, without the revelation of the Lord Jesus Christ.
Yes.
Are y'all agreeing with me there?
Yes.
And once that revelation is pulled off that thing which has covered your eyes, you can get saved. Hallelujah. You can't look into the eyes of Jesus and realize Jesus is God. Hallelujah. And that's your Savior and nothing happened to you. Anytime you come in contact with God, you go away a different person. You cannot come in contact with God and go away the same way you was before you met God. Come on, Lord have mercy. It don't work that way, saints. Anytime you learn the love of God, come in contact, hallelujah, glory to God, with the love of God, hallelujah, you're going to go away a different way. Most of us in here remember the day we met the Lord. Whether you have backslid or not, I remember the day I first met him. Because there's a difference. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. I met him in 1959 and I still remember that. That's a long time ago. But I still remember, hallelujah, the day I met the Lord. Praise the Lord. Come on, y'all. Praise the Lord. And hallelujah. They told me as I go along, hallelujah, my joy would diminish. I would not have the zeal that I had when I first got saved. Guess what? I got more zeal now than I had then. Because I've learned what God will do for an individual if you hold on to it. Hallelujah. I know I do. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Oh, praise the Lord. I know now I don't have to have music to dance with. Praise the Lord. All I do is think on the goodness of Jesus and I can get a dance in you. I can get a breakthrough. Hallelujah. I can get a praise in you. Another thing I've learned. Hallelujah. I don't have to have a whole church full of people to serve the Lord. Oh, glory. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Just me and Jesus. Hallelujah. We can have ourselves a good time. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Sometimes I get up at night. Hallelujah. 3 or 4 o'clock in the morning. Hallelujah. And me and Jesus just having church. Yo, come on. Praise the Lord. Come on. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. We don't have to have nobody. Glory to God. Because when I say Jesus is a good God, I got an amen on the inside. My soul say amen. Hallelujah. I said, the Lord will bring you out. My soul say, yes, he will. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. I said, Lord, there's no God like my God. My soul say amen. Praise the Lord. Something on the inside answers me back. I don't have to have nobody say amen. There's an amen on the inside. Y'all better come on up in this house. When you learn how to praise him by yourself, there's an amen automatically. Come on. Ain't God good? Some say amen. Hallelujah.
Ooh. Hallelujah.
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 Read some.
In whom the God of this world.
In whom the God, which is a small g,
yes.
The God of this world. Has done what?
Have blinded the minds of them that believe not.
Hallelujah. The gods of this world. The gods of this world. Hallelujah. The gods of this world. Paul was talking in terms of the things that takes the place of God in your life. Something like you treasure more than you do the word of the Lord. And some people has taken their children and replace them as God. They love their children like you love God. They love their homes like you love God. He's on. You better not. You better not come in this house with no shoes on. Amen. You pull them shoes off at the door. Praise the Lord. You love that house more than you love God. Clothes. They love clothes better than they do God. And when there's certain clothes, they can't pray in. Certain clothes, they can't sweat in. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. They can't serve the Lord and give him all they got. And when they're dressed up in certain outfits, hallelujah, you got to learn, hallelujah, if the outfit is so good that you can't praise God in, you don't need it on. Because everything you put on, hallelujah, God gave it to you, hallelujah, and it ain't too good for you to praise God. Jesus, Lord have mercy. Hallelujah. You got to be able. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Even if you got it on. Hallelujah. You ought not to be able. You ought to be able to get down on your knees. Hallelujah. Don't talk about this pants is too good for me to get on my knees. No. The only thing, hallelujah, that is good about you is your soul. That is the most valuable thing about you is your soul. Because your soul has to spend eternity somewhere. This old body is going back to the dust. Hallelujah. But the soul is going to spend eternity somewhere with God. And that's the most invaluable thing. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. And so I get down on my knees in my suit. Hallelujah. And save my soul. Hallelujah. That's important. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I guess God going to give me another outfit. Hallelujah. I can't wear this outfit up in glory. God is going to give me another outfit. Jesus, Lord, I love you. Somebody say Jesus. Read some.
Lest the light of the glorious gospel of Christ.
Lest the light of the glorious gospel of Christ.
Who is the image of God.
Who is the image of God.
Should shine unto them.
Should shine into what?
Unto them.
Now, what is he saying here? Praise the Lord. The gospel is here to them that believe not. If you don't believe, you will never get saved.
Amen.
Unbelievers can't get saved.
Amen.
Yes.
Only believers get saved.
Amen.
Amen. Unbelievers, hallelujah. In order for you to get to God, you got to believe that he is.
Yes.
And that he is a rewarder of them that diligently seek him. Praise the Lord. You got to believe when I call him, he going to answer my prayer. You got to believe if I raise my hand and shout Jesus, he going to let me feel him. You got to believe that when I pray, he's going to answer my prayer. You got to believe that there is a God in heaven. Hallelujah. And when I cry, he going to answer my cry. Lucia, come on. This is why people don't get through to God, because they don't believe. Hallelujah. If you believe God, hallelujah, God will show up in your time. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. He that believeth and is baptized. Believe means praise the Lord. It's a verb. It's a moving word. It don't stand still. It moves. Praise the Lord. You can't say you believe and don't move. If you say you believe, praise the Lord, you're going to move. You're going to do something about it. Come on now. If you say you believe in tithes, you're going to pay tithes. If you say you believe in singing, you're going to start singing. If you say you believe in praying, you ain't going to sit there like a knot on a log and ain't nothing coming out of your mouth. You're going to start praying. If you believe, hallelujah, glory to God, that you can go down 95 and get home, you're going to start off going home. Down 95. Because I believe I can get there. Come on, y'all. Praise the Lord. I believe, praise the Lord, if I raise my hand and shout hallelujah, God is going to move somewhere now. The devil is a liar. The devil is a liar. All you got to do is believe what God said. If God said it, I believe it, and that sells it. No use us arguing about it. Don't you and us bickering and debating. God said that. Hallelujah. I mean, and ain't nothing nobody else can do about it. Lord have mercy. Hey, excuse me, please, that fellow shout. Hallelujah. Somebody say praise the Lord. Hallelujah. God said if you just jump up and shout, just jump up and down. Hallelujah. I'll move in your behalf. Hallelujah. Which you gonna sit there and look around. It means you don't believe God. But if God said just jump up and shout, praise the Lord, you don't have to worry about it. Just jump up and shout. If you believe God, it got to come to pass. The Bible says, whosoever calleth on the name of the Lord shall be saved. Hallelujah. Well, what are you doing sitting there? Get up from there and call on his name. Hallelujah. And God said, I'm going to save. Don't sit there and wonder about it and ponder about it and say, if I do it, what's going to happen? No. You say you are a believer. He said, whosoever calleth on the name of the Lord shall be saved. I believe, so I call on his name. Because there's power in his name. Hallelujah. God has put all of the power in the heavens. Praise the Lord. He dumped it in the name of Jesus. And then gave you and I the name. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Glory to God. And told you and I, praise the Lord, whatever you won't ask it in my name and I'll do it. Hey, glory to God. Hallelujah. Amen. If you call on Peter, ain't nothing gonna happen with Peter's name. Call on John, ain't nothing gonna happen in John's name. Oh, Matthew, come by here. Ain't nothing gonna happen in Matthew. Hallelujah. But I dare you to call on Jesus. Hallelujah. I feel like shouting. Praise the Lord. You can call on Jesus and tiredness will leave you. Hallelujah. You can call on Jesus right here tonight, and by the time you get home, it's going to be all right.
Hallelujah.
People refuse to go, hallelujah, to use the thing that's going to help them. Oh, wait. What verse you answer?
Verse 5. For we preach not ourselves.
We preach not ourselves.
But Christ Jesus
but
the
Christ
Lord.
But Christ Jesus the Lord.
And ourselves your servant.
And ourselves your servant for Jesus' sake. I very seldom you hear me say what I did.
Amen.
Hallelujah, because that's not important. It's what the Lord did. Hallelujah. Amen. I laid hands on somebody. Somebody got the Holy Ghost. That's not important. They received the Holy Ghost.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Never mind me. Take me out of it. That's what we got to do. Preach Jesus. Not us. Hallelujah. I was with a group last night, and it was all about me, myself, and I. Hallelujah. That's not important. Me, myself, and I. No. Jesus is the important one. In the midst of the church, if anybody is going to get help, it has to be help of Jesus. If anybody going to get delivered, Jesus has got to deliver. If anybody gets saved, Jesus has got to be the one saved. If anybody get a way made, it's going to have to be Jesus making the way. If anybody get delivered, it's going to have to be Jesus that makes them delivered. Oh my God, I feel the presence of the Lord. Somebody say, praise the Lord. Quit trying to put me, myself, and I in this. Amen. Just leave it up to Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. He got saved. Jesus saved him. He got healed. Jesus healed him. You ain't never healed nobody. Ain't no healing in you, it's in Jesus. Ain't no deliverance in you, it's in Jesus. If you're going to get out of this, it's going to be Jesus get you out of it. If you're going to overcome this feeling that you have in the pit of your stomach, it's going to have to be Jesus that pulled it out of you. God Almighty, I feel the Holy Ghost. Somebody say praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Don't get yourself lined up into nothing. Hallelujah. Give the credit to God. God is due all of the credit. Glory to my Savior. Oh, shut your mouth. Oh, if it had not been the Lord who was on my side, not my education, not how much I know. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. But glory to God. But what God has done for me. Come on now. None of y'all know how to keep yourself. I know you feel like you, because you got education, education. You think you can keep your own self, but you can't keep yourself. You're going to make a mess of stuff. But if God keep you, he knows how to do it. Hallelujah. When God keep you, you preserve. Lord Jesus, help us in this place. He preserved. He knows how to preserve your mind. He knows how to preserve your thought. And he knows when your mind starts dwelling on some stuff, he knows how to move it from there to over here. And when you start feeling funny and crazy, God knows how to take that mind and transform it. Hallelujah. Oh my God. Wait a minute. Hallelujah. Somebody say praise the Lord. I want to tell you this, praise the Lord. All of us, hallelujah. And all of us at some time or another, if you don't keep yourself consecrated, we'll start getting crazy.
Yes.
Hallelujah. You get to the place that, hallelujah, your head gets so giddy, you don't know which way is up or down. Now we still flesh, hallelujah. And hallelujah, and the motions of flesh rises up in us every night. God has to keep the city. That's what the Bible said. Except the Lord keep the city, the watchman watches, but it's in vain. God got to keep this city. And he's talking about this city here, hallelujah. Just pat yourself in the chest and say, this city. God got to keep this city here. Hallelujah. If the Lord don't keep this city, man, you're going to be in trouble. God got to keep this city.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The watchman watcheth, but it in vain. Except the Lord watch out for you. Hallelujah. Because you come face to face and rub shoulders every day with demons.
Thank you, Lord.
And with crazy people. Even we got crazy leaders, hallelujah.
Yes.
And you have to deal with crazy people,
yes.
Frantic people.
Yes.
People are standing on the edge of suicide.
Yes.
And should be in the crazy house.
That's right.
But they're leading us. Hallelujah. And we have to deal with that.
Yes.
Except the Lord watch out for you, man. You ain't gonna make it. God got to watch out. That must see. Just grab somebody's hand and tell them, God, watching out for me. He's looking out for me. Hallelujah. God, hallelujah. Glory. Hey, shatamasita. Glory to my God. Hallelujah. God is watching out for me. Hallelujah. Keep on riding the subway. God watching out for me. Don't you fool yourself. You got crazy people riding in the subway. Hallelujah. You got crazy people. Hallelujah. On these buses. Drugs and everything else riding these cabs. Hallelujah. God got to watch out for you.
Yes.
Read the Lord.
For God.
For God.
Who commanded the light to shine out of darkness.
For God who commanded the light to shine out of darkness.
Has shined in our hearts.
Now, wait a minute. God said, let there be. And there was. It was God who commanded the sun to shine. Hallelujah.
Oh, yeah.
It was God who caused. Now, I want to tell you this, hallelujah. In case you don't remember, there was light before the sun came.
Mm-hmm.
God had light on the earth before the sun came. And he commanded that light to shine before the sun came. Hallelujah. And God separated the day from the night. Praise the Lord. And he put the sun to rule by day and the moon to rule by night. Come on, y'all. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. And that God that said, let there be light, and there was light, that same God shined into your heart. Lord, have mercy. Glory to God. Hallelujah. It was not reading this word. It was the spoken word of God. And what I understand in these verses, God spoke to your spirit, not to your body. He spoke to your spirit, and your spirit made your body get in line. Your body wanted that to be contrary to what was going on, but your body couldn't be contrary because God spoke to your spirit and told your body, hallelujah, to get in line. Oh, have mercy, Jesus. Oh, Jesus. Jesus, Lord, have mercy. Read, sir.
Has shined in our heart. To give the light of the knowledge of the glory of God.
Now, what he was doing, he gave us the glory of the knowledge of God. What did he do? He brought the glory of the knowledge of God. What was that? Hallelujah. He brought light over his knowledge. Knowledge is what? What is knowledge? Knowledge is the art of knowing information. And information can be there, but you don't have no light on it. It's covered up. Hallelujah. The word was here a long time ago before you picked it up. You just didn't have no light on the word. Hallelujah. The word was here before your mom and your dad and your grandma was here. Hallelujah. But you as an individual didn't have no light on the world. The knowledge of it was covered up. But here God is now pulling the cover off the knowledge so you can get it. Lord have mercy. You can live right now. You can do right now. If you get backed in a corner, you know how to come out now. You are in a place you don't have to let nothing take advantage of you, because you know how to beat the devil now. Hey, my God, come on up with you. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. You don't let no devil take your joy. You don't let no devil take your victory. You don't let no devil take over your spirit. Honey, you know how to defeat that devil. You know how to back him up in the corner and to loose you. The blood of Jesus is against you. And the Bible declared, if you rebuke the devil, he'll flee from you.
Hallelujah.
And it didn't say play with him. Why we deal with him is because we play with him. We say, thank you, Mr. Devil, for the test. You a good old devil. You know I love you. Devil, you know I can't get over without you. No, 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 no. You got to learn how to rebuke that devil.
Rebuke that devil.
Back up in the spirit. Hallelujah. And tell him, Lucia, the blood of Jesus is against you. The Lord rebuke you, Satan. Hallelujah. And don't be playing with it. Hallelujah. The devil knows when you're playing with him. Just like that man know when you playing with him and you tell him to quit.
All right, teach us, sir. Teach us.
Hallelujah. That man know when you playing with him. He know when you say, quit now. You mean come, do some more. He know when you're serious with him. You get serious with him, you expose him. I don't care who around you. Take your hands off me.
Right. That's right.
You slimy demon.
Yes, Lord.
Right. Hallelujah.
You don't have to be bothered with him no more.
No more. Yes, Lord.
Jesus, come on. Hallelujah. Every now and then you got to rebuke the devil.
Rebuke the devil.
If you don't rebuke the devil, he'll take over your mind. And the scripture said, let this mind be in you, which was also in Christ Jesus, who thought it not robbery to be equal with God, but made of himself no reputation. The devil, hallelujah, want to take your mind over, because that's where the battlefield is. The battlefield, sister, is in the mind. It's not in the body, it's in the mind. There's a battle going on trying to take over your mind. Lord, I feel like running around in here and y'all getting quiet on it. Hallelujah. Look like I'm going to have to get a little louder. Come on. Pray. Hallelujah. The battlefield, praise the Lord. Touch somebody and tell them the battlefield is in the mind. Hallelujah. The devil want to take over your mind. If he gets your mind, he don't have to worry about the rest of you. He got you. If that devil gets your mind, hallelujah, we can do what we want to do. Hallelujah, you're going to still do what the enemy say is. Praise the Lord. If that devil gets your mind, you can say, I ain't going to do such and such a thing. I ain't going to do such a thing. You just blowing off hot air. You're going to do what your mind say do. Because every man, there's a three part to him. Hallelujah. Right?
Right.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And any two-part rules. Hallelujah. That other part goes with the rest. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Right? Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. So what we have to do is have a spiritual mind. You can take your spiritual mind and control anything you want to control. But you got to have a spiritual mind. I don't care who cheat on you, you can take that spiritual mind and control it. Hallelujah. Get in, Lord. Get in, Lord. Hallelujah. And when God finished with him, he will wish he was dead. God can control anything with a spiritual mind. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. You think some of y'all was, some of us was sitting on a bar stool in a hoobie-jubie that giant. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. When the word came to us, you need to go to church.
Yes.
All of us wasn't in church when that word found us. Some of us was in the bed. Some of us was in the bed with somebody else we weren't supposed to be in with. But the word caught up with you while you was in there. You kick that cover off and say, I got to get out of here. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Lord, have mercy and feel the Holy Ghost. Come on, brothers. Y'all say amen.
Amen.
Thank you. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Let the sisters know y'all over there. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. The word caught up with some of y'all, too. We wasn't doing righteous stuff when the word caught up. But when the word caught up, praise the Lord, all we had to do is obey the word. You don't obey it, hallelujah, you seem like you're going crazy. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Come on. You got the most powerful thing sitting in your chest that God has ever made. And that is his word. Now you are clean through the word which I've spoken unto you. It is the word that cleans you up. It is the word that, hallelujah, eradicates stuff from you. It is the word, praise the Lord, that do stuff to you and make you, hallelujah, clean. Phew, Jesus. Lord, I feel your presence. Hallelujah. Read, sir, read, sir.
In the face of Jesus Christ.
In the face of Jesus Christ. Read.
Well, we have this treasure in now, earthen vessels.
Listen, listen what he says. Oh, Lord. I got to move real quickly. But we have this treasure in earthen vessels. We have this treasure. Just turn to somebody and tell them, I got it in an earthen vessel. What do you have? I have a treasure in an earthen vessel. What's he talking about? I have the Holy Ghost in my physical, natural body. He walks in me. He talks in me. And he tells me I am his own. He dwells on the inside of me. I never leave. He never leaves me. Praise the Lord. Even though, regardless of where I go, he's there. I have it. I have this treasure in an earthen vessel. Anybody have the Lord Jesus Christ have a treasure?
Amen.
Hallelujah. You have riches untold. You have mercy upon mercy. Hallelujah. You have the joy of God that money can't buy. Hallelujah. You have peace that passes all understanding. Hallelujah. Anybody that don't have peace, something is wrong. They're allowing the devil to come in and sabotage what God has already given you. My peace I give unto you. My peace I leave with you. Not as the world giveth I unto you, but give I unto you. I give you peace. Anytime you got the Holy Ghost, God did not leave you with confusion. He left you with peace. Praise the Lord. Somebody say praise the Lord. Now y'all might as well come on. Hallelujah. That's why you can go to church and be here. So that's why you can come here and just sit down and look around. Amen. I saw Mother was here today and she just started looking around. She said, this is such a beautiful place. It's so wonderful in here. Why? The peace that was dwelling on the inside. You have peace here that you don't have at your own home. Oh, have mercy. I'm getting into trouble now. Praise God. But there is a peace abides in this place because we're in the house of the Lord. Come on, y'all. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Glory to my God. Hey, hallelujah. And I have that thing on the inside of my soul. Sometimes, you know, most of us was troubled when we come to the house. We was worried about different stuff. Some of us were worried about if I die, where I'm going to spend eternity. And oh, I don't want to go to hell. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. You just scared to death. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Because you know you was going to hell because you know you didn't have no peace with God. God done something for us.
Yes,
he put a treasure down on the inside.
Yes, he
did. Oh, glory to God. And whatever you want, you can draw from that treasure.
Yes.
When you got a treasure, you can go to that treasure and get what you need.
That's right.
Come on, y'all. Praise the Lord. You need joy, you can go get some joy. You need peace of mind, you can go get some peace of mind. Hallelujah. You need deliverance? You can go get some deliverance. You've got it on the inside. There's no need for you sitting up in here and don't use your treasure. Dip into that treasure and get what you need and go on with the Lord. Don't let no devil push you in the back, up in a corner, praise the Lord, and make you lose your mind. That's silly. That's crazy. Hallelujah. When you got peace on the inside, and that's a treasure on the inside, tell the devil you can have anything, but you can't have my mind. You can have my coat, but you can't have my mind. I'm not losing my mind over no foolishness. I'm not losing my mind on no stupid stuff. no. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Click that. Hallelujah. I got a treasure on the inside. Dip in your treasure. Hallelujah. And get out of what you need from God. You know I need a little more joy, Lord. Hallelujah. Dip in there and get some more joy. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. With joy, we draw water out of the wells of salvation. Delight yourself in the law of the Lord. And in God's law do ye meditate. For he shall be like a tree that's planted by the rivers of water, bringing forth his fruit in his season. His leaves shall not wither. And whatsoever he do, he shall prosper. Glory to God. Hallelujah. You like a tree that's planted by the rivers of water. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Rivers of water. Rivers of water. Just talk to somebody and say, rivers of water.
Hallelujah.
Your roots is laying in the river. Come on. Hallelujah. You ain't got no dry river. Your river ain't dried up. You got a river there. Hallelujah. All of the joy you want, you can draw out of this river. Don't let no devil drive you crazy. Loose your hope. Get out of here. Wait a minute. Where we at?
Verse 7. That the excellency of the power may be of God and not of us.
That the excellence of the power may be of God and not us. Don't do nothing to show off you. Well, I'm a powerhouse. You ain't nothing. I got power. Big hands. You ain't got nothing.
That's right.
Hallelujah. Your power should be of God and not yourself. When you preach a good message, hallelujah, give God the credit. Not somebody else. Give God all the credit.
Hallelujah.
The credit is due God. He's the one gave you the mind to be saved. He's the one to give you the mind to run after him. Now, listen. God is the only one knows what he wants to satisfy him. And if he knows what he wants to satisfy him, he didn't have to tell you what it was. He could have left it up to you. But God is so good. Until he tells you what I want to satisfy me. Not only do that what I want, I'm going to help you get what it takes to satisfy me. Because I know you don't have it on the inside, so I'm going to give you what it takes to satisfy me. My God, that's a good God. If he wasn't a good God, he would leave it up to you and let you blunder and plunder and see what you can come up with. But God don't do that. Hallelujah. He allows you, hallelujah, to come to him, and then he tells you what I want to satisfy me. Because I want you to be saved. Hallelujah. What does it take, Lord? It takes praises. And I want you to give me praise. Whatever's going on in your life, just give me praise. Whatever's happening in your life, just give me praise. Whatever it looked like, just give me praise. Whatever it seemed like, just give me praise. And I'll work the situation out in your life. Oh my God. Hey, Jesus, Jesus. All right. All right, I'm almost through here. Hallelujah. Now, praise the Lord. Listen what he says. Hallelujah. Listen what he says. Listen what God says. I wanted to give you another scripture, but my time is running out.
Come on, give us
a few minutes. Hallelujah. Listen what he says. in the 8th verse, in the 8th verse, he changes his tactics and his story, because he ends with the 7th verse and talks about the power of God alone. He talks about the only way that's going to deliver you from the mess we're in is the power of God. You would be surprised to know how much power it takes from God, hallelujah, to cause an individual to live holy a day. And to save an individual, praise the Lord, it took God to take his sacrifice and hang his sacrifice on a cross. It took God to take his sacrifice to crucify his sacrifice. It took God to take his sacrifice and put it in a tomb. It took God, hallelujah, to take his sacrifice, Jesus, hallelujah, and go down into hell where Satan was and see about Jeremiah, Ezekiel, Hosea, and Zephaniah, and see about the old saints. And it took God to prophesy through David. And David said, Thou will not cause thy Holy One to see corruption. Neither will thou suffer me, my soul, hallelujah, hallelujah, to be lost in hell. Hallelujah. And when Jeremiah saw him, hallelujah, he came through 40 and 2 generations. Hallelujah. What was he doing? I'm coming out of hell because there is a body that I have to fuse with life again. So the future heroes, hallelujah, could have hope. Because when you die, you are disconnected from life and from God. And it's going to take somebody that is full of life, praise the Lord, to hook up to your dead body and bring you back alive. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And he could only do that if he died. Because he had to offer the ultimate sacrifice for man's sin. Lord have mercy. Y'all get up from here. Hallelujah. I feel the Holy Ghost. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank the Lord. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Oh, bless his name. Bless his name. Bless his name. Bless his name. Thank God. Thank God. Hallelujah. So he changes his subject in this verse. Hallelujah. And he says in the 8th verse, read, sir.
We are troubled on every side.
We are troubled on every side. Every side we turn around, there is trouble. Jesus, hallelujah. If it ain't one thing, it's another. Nobody gonna live saved and ain't going through nothing. Because the scripture said, many afflictions of the righteous, but the Lord shall deliver him out of them all.
Oh, yes.
We are troubled, sis, on every side. Glory to God. Hallelujah. We are troubled. If you ain't having no trouble, you ain't saved. If nobody ain't bothering you, remember the devil already got you. You living in peace and ain't nobody bothering you. Hell ain't being raised nowhere about you. Praise the Lord. The devil already got you. So ain't no need to raise Satan, because I got you. You working for me. But there's a few of us, hallelujah, every time the sun rises, we try to wonder what the next day going to bring. We are troubled on every side. I don't care if you're living by yourself. You're going to have some trouble. Ain't nobody in there but you. You gonna give you some trouble. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Trouble on every side, but what?
Yet not distressed.
But not in distress. I know where to go to, Mother Ruth. No, yes, when I have trouble, hallelujah, I ain't losing my mind. I know where to go to. I know what to do. Hallelujah. I ain't backsliding. I know what to do. I ain't throwing in no towel. I know what to do. I ain't going to nobody get no liquor. I ain't going to nobody to read my palm. I know what to do. I ain't hiding from no demon. I know what to do. Y'all might as well come on up in here today. Praise the Lord. This is the word that the Lord gave me. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I'm troubled on every side, but yet not in distress. I know where to go. Grab somebody's hand and tell them I know where to go. Hallelujah. Come on, you better lose your hope. Come on, you better lose your hope. Lose your hope. Lose your hope. Get with this word. It'll help you. Hallelujah. Trouble on every side. If not in distress, I know what to do. People are losing their mind because they don't know what to do.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. People are killing one another because they don't know what to do. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. That's why. Hallelujah. That's why that boy told his mama out the window because he didn't know what to do. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And I have just as much trouble as anybody, but I know what to do. Y'all might as well come on in this house and y'all know y'all have some trouble.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
You know you have some trouble. Yes. Praise the Lord. But before the trouble catch up with you, pray you know what to do.
Yes.
I ain't staying home either.
That's right.
Because that's what the devil wants you to do. And he do that because, praise the Lord, the way the devil got it figured out, and this is right, y'all put this down, write this down in your heart somewhere or another. The trick of the devil is to divide and conquer. If he can divide us, he can conquer us. Y'all might as well put that down, put it in your memory bank. Divide and to conquer. His job from 6 o'clock in the morning, praise the Lord, until 6 o'clock in the evening is to divide. All I want to do is divide you and conquer you. Hallelujah. Because if we stay together, we have power. There's nothing like Holy Ghost power. Come on now, we can get rid of anything if we stay together. Two sticks is harder to break than one.
Yes, it is true.
If you get these two sticks together, then you're going to have a tough time breaking them.
That's right.
Hallelujah. But if they get separated, you can snap them.
That's what happens.
Hallelujah. And that's what the devil wants to do. He wants to snap you. And when you snap or break, you're disconnected. And when you're disconnected, there's no unity nowhere. And when there's no unity, praise the Lord, you will fall. I'm standing tall. It's just a matter of time. Man was made this way. Man was made to have fun. Man was made to have joy. God made joy for man. He didn't make it for no beast. He made it for man. He made you to be joyful. He made for you to have some fun. He made for you to laugh. Don't sit there like a sour prune. Hallelujah. And don't want to laugh. Laugh. Laugh, laughter is medicine to the bone. If you can laugh, hallelujah, you can dunk some stuff. If you can laugh, you can keep your mind. Oh, Jesus. I don't know where the word is, but I'm just going to the word. Hallelujah. God wants us to laugh. I'm sure Jesus laughed with his disciples. That's just one of his personalities. Would you think people wanted to be around him all the time? He wasn't always giving instructions and telling people that they ain't saved and telling them, amen, who they are. Amen. He was having fun. God wants us to have fun.
Yes.
Turn to somebody and say, fun. Praise the Lord. Don't, if you're going in a church and they ain't having no fun, you better get up out of there. You want people to laugh. You want people to talk and have fellowship with one another. What happens when you stop having fun, then you get nosy into other people's business. And when you know everybody's business, then you don't even know your own business. Then you become sour and bitter. God didn't intend for you to be bitter. But when you know my business, his business, that business, and everybody else's business, hallelujah, it takes something away from you. You're too loaded. You just got, if you just deal with your business, your little 2 cent worth of business, if you deal with your 5 cent worth of business, you'd be all right. This is killing the church. This is killing the church. Hallelujah. We was in a meeting and we have some people walking around the room and finding out about people, learning about people, searching people out. That's crazy. Why you want to know whether I'm married or not? Why you want to know how many times I've been to jail? Why you want to know my record? Why you want to know where my birthmark at? What good that's going to do you? The only thing going to do you good is how close I can get to God. That should be the primary interest of the saint of God. I'll let nothing separate me from the love of God. How much I know, that shouldn't matter with you.
Amen.
What school you went to, where you get all that knowledge. See, you want to sugarcoat stuff, and we ain't going to sugarcoat. That shouldn't be a part of your theory or your vernacular. Your vernacular should be how much I got to do to get closer to God.
Yes.
Yes.
What's going to help me overcome my next hurdle?
Yes. All right.
What's going to put this in close so I can lay hands on the sick? Not criticize because I'm laying hands and people have been delivered. Oh, my church is prospering and yours ain't. That should not be. Because if you suffer like I suffer, hallelujah. The Bible said, if you suffer with me, you shall reign with me. Wait a minute. Reason.
We are perplexed.
We are perplexed.
But not in despair.
We are perplexed. Perplexed is my mind is troubled. Things are going on and I don't really understand. Perplexities of the mind. Things are getting to my mind. I don't understand why you're doing that. I don't understand why you're saying that. Why would your mind be there? If you got a clean mind, Holly, why your mind going that way? If I drop Sister So and So off, praise. Why your mind had to go dirty?
Ooh, Jesus.
know, you don't have to call up somebody and ask them, do you know, Bishop, no sister, so and so, there must be something going on. No, all you got to do is pray. God is a revealer. Hallelujah. You don't have to call no trouble. Just get on your knees and pray. And if I ain't living right, God will show it to you.
Amen.
Come on, Lord, have mercy. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And hallelujah. If you, Lord Jesus. Come on, hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Read some.
Persecuted.
Listen what he says. First, he deals with the flesh. Next thing, he's dealing with the mind. I'm perplexed, but what?
But not in despair.
But not in despair. When an individual gets in despair, he has nothing else to do but try to destroy something or cause pain. You in despair, you want somebody painting like you painting, and that's not good. God didn't put you here for that. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Now what you need to do, hallelujah, hallelujah. You're not supposed to be perplexed to the place that it causes you pain. Before you get there, hallelujah, it's something and you can't figure it out, get on your knees.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Hallelujah.
Something is happening and it don't come to me yet what is happening. Praise the Lord. But the scripture said, cast all your cares upon him, for he careth for thee.
Yes, yes.
Then, Lord, you got to make this thing known to me. I don't know what's happening to me tonight. Praise the Lord. Somebody say praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Read, bro.
Persecuted. But not forsaken.
No. Persecuted is what people are saying. Persecute somebody is to accuse them of stuff. Hallelujah. Accuse them of stuff you have no evidence. Hallelujah. You are persecuting folk. Hallelujah. You are saying what people are doing and you have no clue.
Clueless.
Hallelujah. You don't know what I've done, hallelujah, to get where I'm at. You don't know how many times I rolled up to the George Washington Bridge with no money in my pocket and told the agent I'll be back by the next night to pay you for this cross. You don't know how many Christmases that my kids miss. You don't know how many times I wore a suit until the suit was shining. You don't know how much I suffered to get here. And here you persecuting of stuff you have no idea. Oh my goodness. This is what Paul is saying. This is what Paul is not talking to a world. He's talking to the church. Grab somebody's hand and tell him he's talking to me. I know you don't want to say it, but say it anyhow. Tell him he's talking to me. Persecuted. But what?
Not forsaken.
But not forsaken. God didn't forsake. When people persecute you, hallelujah, I'm glad God don't forsake you because they persecute you. Y'all might as well come on. I feel like shouting. I'm so glad that God don't leave you because of what you said about me. Grab somebody's hand and say, I'm so glad that God don't leave me because of what you said about me. I know what she was doing. I know what she was doing. Hey, you don't even know. You don't know when I got any food in the refrigerator or when I got a jar of ice water. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Lord have mercy. Glory. Hallelujah. And hallelujah. And Messiah. Oh, glory. A saint learned how to praise God in the midst of his persecution. Persecuted, but not forsaken. Read to
cast down.
Listen, people throw you, people cast you down. They walk on you. It seems as though our theme is that the saints use the saints for a walking act. This is what Paul was saying. They walk on me. They even rub their feet off, clean their feet off on me. Come on now, yo. I'm reading the word. Come on, that's what the word says. Hallelujah. Pray. I'm cast down. Hallelujah. Every saint of God should be the supporter of each other. Now listen, hallelujah. God gave us, there are nine gifts in the spirit. There are nine gifts, and if we start reading the New Testament church, there are more than nine gifts in the church. Praise the Lord. But one gift God never gave the saints. Hallelujah. And just shake somebody's hand and said, he never gave the saints this gift. The gift of judging. God never gave you the gift of judging. He gave you the gift of discernment, but not judging. Judging is left to God. Discernment is to know what it is. Hallelujah. I want you to know what this is, but you don't pronounce judgment on it. Oh, Jesus, Lord, have mercy. Y'all might as well come on. Hallelujah. I know this is an apple that I'm eating. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. But God never gave you the right to judge it. Hallelujah. Judge nothing before time. And your judgment time is not now. In the rapture. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. This is when the saints will judge the world. But not now. We spoke to discern. And discern means, hallelujah. Discern means to know. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. But hold your judgment. Hallelujah. Come on in this house tonight. I know I got this one right. Praise the Lord. Somebody say, praise the Lord. Hallelujah. You ought to know when an individual come in here and they don't have the right spirit. You ought to know when a preacher is preaching, whether he's preaching word or whether he's preaching what he learned in the conference. You ought to know when a preacher or anybody else is saying something and it's not word. You ought to be shrewd enough to know the word when you hear it. Because when you hear the word, I'm going to tell you how. When you hear the word, something in you clicks. When you live right. Y'all might as well come on, hallelujah. Because the word is the thing that brings life. And God comes to bring life to that which is dead. I gotta wake up the thing that's on the inside of you. And how do I wake it up? It's with the word. Singing gonna wake it up. His word wake it up. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Word of bickering and debating doesn't wake it up. His word wake it up. Thy word, oh God, have I hid in my heart that I might not, Lord Jesus, you can get around the word and you can't keep your hand down. If the word start coming, your hand will start, it just automatically start moving. Your foot automatically start moving when the word start coming. Oh, you have anybody in here believe this thing. Something start happening to your body. It's the word start making connection with the word. Thy word, oh God, have I hid in my heart. That word that you got hid in your heart is being connected with the word that Hallelujah. Glory. Hey, glory to my God. Hallelujah. Praise the name of my God. Hallelujah. Glory to my God. I feel it. Hallelujah. I feel it. I feel the word.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you.
Hallelujah. That logos. Start connecting with the word.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
All right. What is it?
But not destroy.
But not destroy. I am would rake all that mess they put on me. All that junk they throw on me, mama. All that talking that they do to me. I'm still not destroyed.
Hallelujah.
Now y'all do what you want, but I'm telling you, the saints know how to put some stuff on you. Hallelujah. People will put it on you. Hallelujah. Yes, but I'm not destroyed. Every hallelujah, I want to come back to church. Just grab somebody's hand and tell them I'm back. Hallelujah. I'm back. Hallelujah. I know you thought I was dead, but I'm back. I know you thought I was out the race, but I'm back.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. You thought the shout was over, but I'm back.
I'm back.
You thought I was gonna quit because of what you said about me. Honey, but thank you. You just stirred up something on the inside of me. You thought I was gonna quit, go home and soak. Hallelujah. That's what the devil wanted me to go home and soak and just cry myself to sleep. Hallelujah. But I went home and I prayed myself. And God told me to come on back out here.
Hallelujah.
And raise your hand and say, now unto him who is able to keep me from falling. He's able to present me father before his throne with exceeding joy. Let the devil know that I'm still able. Though you slay me, yet will I trust him. All the days of my appointed time will I wait. Come on up in this house. I'm going to wait until my change
comes.
Hallelujah. 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 Amen. Wait on the Lord. They that wait on the Lord. Oh, grab somebody's hand and tell them they that wait on the Lord. Lord, I feel like having church today. Oh, come on. Just shake your hand and say they that wait on the Lord. He shall renew their strength. I got some new strength. God gave me some new strength last night. Around about 4 o'clock in the morning, God came through. Hallelujah. He said, you shut your mouth and come on here. I'm gonna fight your battle for you. You just hold your peace. I'm gonna bring you out of this. I'm gonna be your joy. Read those.
Always bearing about in the body the dying of the Lord Jesus.
Can you imagine here Jesus dying on the cross and he hollered, ooh, Lordy, Lord, come help me. This stuck up in my leg. Jesus, Lord, help me, Lord. Lord, help me, Lord. They put the spear in my belly. Help me, Lord. Lord, they just whipped me all night long, and all I done was right. I never said nothing about nobody, and they just whipped me until I'm swelling. Lord, just help me. Could you imagine Jesus talking like that? Now, he come here to die for us. Praise the Lord. And he hollered. Come on now, what was you going to do? Can you imagine? You can't imagine. Let me say it again. Can you imagine Jesus hollering? He was the one that came down to save us, to offer his body on the cross for you and I. But when the thing got hot, he started hollering.
Hollering.
Y'all might as well come on, I know y'all looking at me strange, but could you imagine Jesus hollering? Hallelujah. If Jesus had started hollering and would have said, look, I don't think I'm going to die, you and I have been messed up.
That's
right. Oh, praise Him. Oh, Jesus, Lord have mercy. My time is out. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Amen. Put your hand together and give God praise. Amen.